Welcome to Take a Wonder with Shebs. Now my guest today is Sinje Stoitzner. Sinje is a very charismatic travel vlogger and a consultant in Kenya who is focused on helping women to experience the cultures of Kenya. I also spoke to her about her business in general, where she wants to educate tourists and travelers who want to visit Kenya. All of that and much more in my discussion with Sinje. So let's take a look. Sinje, thank you so much for coming on the show. I really appreciate your time. How are you?
I'm very fine this morning.
Thank you very much. I've been looking forward to talking to you, especially about your business and your work. So just for people who don't know who you are, just explain a little bit about yourself.
So my name is Sinje, and I've been traveling over 7 years, and I'm a female solo traveler in Kenya. And I just love traveling in Kenya and also helping other women to explore Kenya and to travel in Kenya as well.
Awesome. We'll come on to your business, as I said, slightly later. So I just want to take it back and ask you a little bit about yourself and where your initial love for traveling started. So for you, where did it all begin?
Yeah, it's actually a crazy story for myself because I never grew up in a traveler family. So even until today, I'm the only one in my family, and I'm one out of five kids, and my family's, they don't really travel. So what happened is, when I was a student in university, I'm a teacher by profession, I heard older students talking about their internship in Africa. That time it was in South Africa. And they told me about their safari and their experience, how they were combining going on safari, but also volunteering in a school as a teacher. And how they talked about this experience just fascinated me and moved me somewhere inside, which I couldn't describe. And since that day, I told myself, hey, I'm going to travel to Africa. I have to go and experience. And that's how I did it. And that's from that moment, I changed and I looked for a way, for an opportunity on how I can travel to Africa the first time in my life. And that's how I did it.
My degree was in the arts, but I always had a ambition to travel because I travel very young, and that's where I really got a hook to it. When was the moment that you felt to yourself, "Oh, this is it, really"?
The way I grew up was that we used to go, especially to Spain, France, Italy for holiday. So I was used to the beach holidays and just exploring this kind of hotel lifestyle and 5-star hotels and all inclusive, and I never experienced the way of backpacking and exploring and going for adventure and going to mingle and learn from new cultures. And when I heard, like I was in my second year in university, when I heard from other students that this is possible and we can go on an internship and travel to Africa and what it actually means going outside of Europe, because I have never thought about it, to be honest. My mind never crossed going outside of Europe. I was never interested. So that was really the moment which changed me completely. And the following morning, I actually asked one of my teammates, one I study with, and I asked her, there's a way we can go on an internship. That time it was to Ghana. Will you join me? Because I was so scared. I was so worried. I was like, I can't go alone. My English was very, very broken as a German. And I was just scared. And she was a traveler. She used to go to Australia even before university. So I felt secure with her. So I asked her, and then we said, okay, why not? And from there, we started the procedure of applying for the internship. And that's how I landed the first time going to Africa.
So you're based in Kenya, I believe, as well. You've delved into a business of yours where you help women. So just explain to people what your business is and what it's called and everything.
Sure. So my business is called Travel with Sinje, which is basically travel with me. But you don't always, of course, have to travel with me, and I don't always travel with my clients. But the main idea is, when I came the first time to Kenya or to Africa, it changed the way I saw the world. So, and I want to give women the opportunity as well to be changed by travel. The first time I came to Kenya, okay, let's say the second day, because the first day I was in a cultural shock. But the second day, from there, I fell in love with Africa, and I discovered a part inside me, inside my heart, which I never knew it even exists before. So for me, to get that change and that opportunity to be changed. That's what I want to give and what I want to help other women to get as well. And as I mentioned already, why women? I love supporting women, okay, easily because I am a woman. And I think as a woman traveling in Africa, and then especially as a solo traveler, I went there just by myself to Kenya. I traveled there the first time for 6 months without knowing anyone, not even knowing proper English, nothing. And I did it. And I know I was scared. I was really, really scared. And the first time I traveled to Africa, it was to Ghana, I would have not done it if I would have not made to convince my best friend. So, and I want to give women the opportunities. I mean, they can travel with their friends, yes, but also solo travelers who are alone at home and they think, okay, I don't have my best friend, or my best friend, she doesn't want to go to Kenya, or she's working all the time, or she doesn't have money, or whatever the issue is. I still want to help this woman to get out of their comfort zone and just realize their dreams, because you might be changed for life, like the way I did. So I basically never returned back home to Germany. Since I came to Kenya the first time in 2014, something shifted inside me so that I stayed. Of course, I went back home, I packed my things, I finished my studies, but I was sure I'm not living in Germany anymore. So I broke up even with my boyfriend at that time. I arranged everything. And then directly after my last internship as a teacher, I completely moved to Kenya. And that's where I am today.
So those are very bold moves to make. So especially as you just said, they're breaking up with your boyfriend, you know, a real shift in your life and moving across to Kenya. And you said, obviously, as a solo female traveler as well, and there's a lot of misconceptions sometimes about Africa, but you wanted to show that as a woman, which is why you said it was important to start the business for women as well. We touched on it a little bit, why it's important for women. So how do you help women then? What is the sort of business?
So I basically make you feel comfortable and help you to plan everything for your travel from A to Z. Even after Z, the moment you arrive in Kenya, if you wish, you can book me or hire me as a travel guide, travel leader, and I travel with you as well on top. So that's a service on top we can also book in case you are really worried or scared, or you just simply want to have someone traveling with you or company. Or I used to have like one client, she was already older, or another client, she only talked in German, so she wanted me to be there to help her. Yeah, just company and organizing everything. But basically how it works, the concept is, I am an independent travel consultant. So that means the moment you reach out to me, or maybe you have followed me on my social media, you found me, you reach out to me, then what I will do, I will actually not really listen to you until we schedule a call. Because for me, it's very important that we get this personal connection. And you see, traveling to Kenya or to Africa, or in general, if you go on a holiday, when my clients or my typical clients come to Kenya, it's not just about going on safari and getting to the beach. There's always something behind, something inside you deeper. Maybe you don't know it yet why, but there's a reason why you're traveling. And there's a specific reason which is individually only for you, what you want to experience. So maybe you are into culture. Maybe you are a yoga type. Maybe you want to run away, whatever, from your ex, or you want to start a new life. You want to go and have something out of the norm, whatever. So in that call, we are scheduling, which is totally for free. So I do this with every client. I get them on a call, Zoom call, or just via WhatsApp video call. And then we connect. I get to know you. You get comfortable with me. And then from there, we take the procedure if you want to. So, which means I help you planning everything. So I come up with a trip for you. I suggest you, okay, in your type, maybe ABCD would make sense. Or you can do this. And then, of course, according to your budget, when you are coming, what you want to do. And then I will share with you different itineraries after the call. But it's way more than that. I am here more like, I would say, as a friend. So I help you also if you have questions. Because most of my clients, they wonder about, okay, Sinha, is it even safe as a woman? So that's one of the biggest questions female solo traveler have. So I have created also a free training, which I then after the call share with my clients. They can just watch and they learn things about how to be crime proof, just basically how to get the confidence of traveling as a woman in Africa. Because it's still quite different traveling in Africa compared to Europe or to the USA. So yeah, as well, if you need help in applying for a visa, so it's more like a 24/7 hours, like I am there for you via WhatsApp, via Instagram, before your trip, while your trip. And even of course, if you want after your trip, because I do connect with my clients, which I, when they come to Kenya, are not clients for me anymore. I make sure, of course, if possible, that we can even meet up, because most of the clients, they land in Nairobi, of course. That's our international airport. So I will live in Nairobi directly. So I also make sure I welcome them in Nairobi if possible, and if the client wants to. So we can meet up for dinner or for lunch, or even to the extent that I travel with them for 1-2 days. Depending on our schedules.
From what everything that you just said there is, sounds very bespoke. You know, there's a personal touch to it, which makes it more comfortable for any women who are coming in for the first time, especially, as I said to you, to a place where there's been misconception maybe in the Western media. You've got that touch to say, hang on, I'm from Germany, I'm from the Western world, it's all fine. So you've got that touch. Yeah. I think that's what would you say then makes your business different to others? Because I have spoken to a few people who have got very similar businesses where they will have a very bespoke cases of you, you can travel to Kenya, this is what we can do for you. So what makes you so different?
Of course, number one, myself, but I wouldn't say that as number one point. What I truly believe in, and as well, I do as well, I run an organization, Ithika, which I co-founded the first time I came to Kenya. So we support orphans in the slum. And my concept is, while traveling, to support the local communities. So my typical clients, which are females, but they do as well love traveling and supporting locals, and as well, not only supporting locals, also living with the locals or exploring culture. Because in Kenya, we have over 43 tribes. And if any tribe is known, then maybe the Maasai, which is a fascinating tribe. And I love working with the Maasai. I have villages where clients can sleep over and they really get into the Maasai culture, which means they can be part of a survival training. They can learn about healing plants, sit with the Maasai in the evening at the bonfire and dance and get their stories and learn more about their cultures. And as well, I am more known for being specialized in Samburu and the northern parts of Kenya, because it's more like a remote area. So it's more like the travel for tourists, where I mean traveling with not many tourists. So, and this is the Samburu tribe, which is similar to the Maasai tribe. So they are dressed very similar, have a similar culture. And there I work, for example, with a women's only village. And this attracts a lot of women who say, yes, I want to come. I want to visit this village. Sinya, can you take me exactly to this village? Because this village is only for women. So which means Samburu women, they fight against their own culture. They fight against their own men. Because still in Samburu and Maasai culture, there are a lot of things like FGM and the girls are not going to school. I mean, it's changing now, luckily. Even girls are going to school. But let's say 10 years ago, girls did not have the right to go to school. Or let's say the fathers always chose the boys going to school. And it's still happening today. And FGM, of course, is a big, big topic. And just basically giving the woman a right to speak, the right to choose. Because a lot of women are not having any rights there. You get married as a third, fourth, fifth, sixth wife, and you can't do anything. So where do you go when you get beaten up, or where do you go when something happens to you? So in this village, they made sure that they are like a refuge place for women who have trouble at home or who want to make a change in their life, who wants to who want to be independent. And yeah, so it's a very, yeah, that's just one of the projects or organizations I work with. And these are very interesting projects. And a lot of clients find me through that because I've been working with the Women's Village for over 3 years now. So I'm very close to Rebecca Lodosoli, which is one of the co-founders there. And yeah, clients find me through that as well. And then I connect them with Rebecca or I travel with them there. Depends on their time and the rest of their itinerary.
It's very admirable for your business to actually have that, I guess, humanitarian aspect. Yeah. You know, you've put your, because a lot of businesses, I'm sure a lot of businesses out there, when they start, the main goal is to start making money, start making it profitable. But your heart was in the right place in terms of you wanted to give back. And I think that's really important, giving back to the community, considering you've come from a different country yourself and you've recognized that you've not just come for the money and the business and, you know, trying to grow yourself as just as a business, but you wanted to give back. And that's very, very, to be fair, I've not spoken to businesses who've done that actually. So that makes you very unique in that sense. So I guess, what challenges have you faced though, whilst you started the business and where it is? I guess, where is the business now from where it was when you first started and the challenges you faced?
The funny thing is that I never came to Kenya with the idea of starting a business. Or I never even came to Kenya with the idea of I'm going to live in Kenya. So let's start from there. So when I came, what made me stay and fall in love with Kenya was the organization I co-founded back in 2014. So the first 4 years I lived volunteering in my own organization I co-founded and making sure the kids are okay. We fundraise, we co-founded an organization in Germany, which is today one of the biggest parts because they're our, let's say 99% our sponsors for the organization in Kenya. And since I managed that this project works basically without me, we have a full Kenyan team who works. We have a full German team who works. So I could take myself more out and I never earned any money because that was volunteering. That was my project. Like what I wanted to do, I wanted to give back and help the kids. And but then there comes a time, of course, you need money. I was a student. I had a very low budget lifestyle. And I used to live in a village in Dika, which is around 1 hour away from Nairobi. And in this time, how I got also sponsors and attention and made all this happen was I blogged a lot in social media, that time, especially in Facebook. So I got a lot of people reaching out to me and asking me, Sinia, oh, you are in Kenya, right? I want to go on safari. Can you help me? Oh, I have this question and I have this and this and this. And at the beginning, honestly, I just had so many women or, especially women connected with me on the social or on platforms. I had them all for free without having any business model. I mean, just to the extent I could, because traveling in Kenya is not cheap. Traveling in Kenya is really expensive. If you have ever gone on a safari, you will know how much money you pay. So that time, I was a volunteer. I was broke. I had nothing. And then you asked me about safari tips. And I just tried. And then I helped connecting you with other tour operators, which I knew. And that's how I slowly, very, very slowly, actually the first time when my brother came to see me here in Kenya, and he told me, Sinia, I want to go on safari, is when I seriously started thinking and okay, let me see, because I just don't want him to connect with anyone. I want to make sure he's safe, he's okay, he has a good experience. And that's when I started reaching out to tour companies, getting involved with them, and I just got more and more and more requests online, so that I started selling or becoming an agent for low budget tours in Kenya, because that time I was a low budget traveler. But then I have changed, like my life has upgraded. I started traveling myself. The way of I live now compared to 3 years ago, the way of I travel now is very differently. Like now I work with all kind of lodges. I work with all kind of organizations, tour operator together. I think the biggest challenge is to stand out and to get traffic for your business. Because once I had like figured out of what I want, like at the beginning, as I said, I never had an idea of, okay, And I'm also not into tourism. Like, I am a teacher by profession. So my biggest challenge was more like they call it imposter syndrome, or more like with myself, like, who am I to sell safaris? Who am I to guide others to help traveling in Kenya? I don't have a tourism degree. And I always say, I don't have it. So this was my biggest problem. But my experience stood out. The good reviews of my clients helped me to overcome that. So that was number one. And number two is simply getting the attraction, getting the traffic, getting enough leads, which you can convert at the end of the day. And now I'm growing. Even my YouTube now has just, I can see when I follow my analytics, I'm still a small YouTuber, but the algorithm is picking it up slowly. My Instagram, now I'm almost reaching 10,000. It's coming, and I'm getting DMs. I'm getting my lead magnet works. And now, of course, in these uncertain times here, there have been less travelers. But the last few months, it has been picking up again. And I think this is the biggest challenge all tour operators right now have, or all travelers, that we basically have this fear outside in the world of not traveling.
The biggest challenge is the pandemic, has been the pandemic. And how have you managed to sort of get by that without the business that you would have had pre the pandemic?
So it had positive sides, of course, as well. Then the negative ones is the financial part. Let's start with the positive. It gave me a lot of freedom, a lot of time for myself to travel as well and to explore. Like, all our lodges and our tours here, they have really reduced their prices during this time right now. So which means that we as locals could travel for a small amount. Or I have luckily come to a situation that I don't even pay for traveling anymore. So I only stay at accommodations if they invite me or if they sponsor me. Or yeah, I have a kind of contract or something with the lodges. So I got lucky and used all this time to travel for myself, to explore, to make travel vlogs and all these things. But at the same time, of course, you need money. So what I did and what I still do, but now very less right now in this moment, the fact that I'm a teacher, I help especially German families, or let's say mixed families, which they want them kids to be in the German school, or most of the families, maybe their mother is German or only their father is German, and they live here in Nairobi. And now because of online schooling, they need support in the school system. So they hire me as a private teacher to my own schedule, just like 1 hour here, 1.5 hours here, 2 hours here, multiple times in a week to different families. So that's how I overcame personally that situation financially, which worked for me personally very well. But of course, this was just to overcome this season, this period. And now I'm back into being a travel consultant.
We've had, in fact, in the United Kingdom, where a lot of the travel industry, pilots, you name it, struggling really badly. And we're talking about here, we're a country that's meant to be a first world country. So for you to survive that is absolutely amazing. One of the things I wanted to ask you was about how competitive you are compared to your other competitors, I guess.
At the beginning, when I started, I always thought, okay, you have to be cheap. You have to be very competitive, but there will be always a cheaper and a cheaper and a cheaper. And until I realized it's not about money, and it's never about money. It's about the change you create in people's life. It's about the transformation process. And it's about the experience you can get. And this makes me stand out to my competitors, because if you want to travel, for example, to a woman's village, or if you want to have a certain cultural experience, it's hard to find it somewhere else. I'm not saying I'm the only one who does that, but the only one maybe who does it in my way, like the only one with the concept of giving back, with the concept of having supported them for years over years over years. And my clients do appreciate that. And I would say from the price range, it's medium budget. So it's nothing. I'm certainly not the cheapest, and I don't want to be the cheapest because we love paying our drivers, our cars, and everything to a fair price and a fair service, because it's all about, for my company, it's all about supporting locals, and it starts with your own employees.
Mention your socials as well. So you've built a good socials media platform for it. As you said, the YouTube, I've watched some of your videos, and as you said, your Instagram's growing. Was that another conscious thing to do whilst you were doing all your business outside? You wanted to make sure your social was growing? Because I guess that's a great way of getting the word out about the business.
Definitely. And I'm not even a Facebook type. That was like years ago when I started. I didn't know Instagram that well. So I just started Instagram a few years ago, to be honest. And Instagram was always more like a personal thing. Like, I am just a person. If you even, guys, if you want to follow me on my Instagram, on my stories, I'm there like almost every day. And I film myself. I talk about my daily life. I talk about my experience. And when I travel, I love traveling and sharing my experience. And this has something from inside me, which I always had, and I discovered while traveling, that I have the feeling of I need to share it. So this is something natural I have. Nothing like some content creators or travel agents. Like, I have partners I work with, they are shy of the cameras. They don't even want to take a picture. So I'm exact the opposite. I go, I talk, I interview, I just take videos. So Instagram has been more like a personal thing, which I have been grown very easily and very fast, which I'm very happy. And YouTube was a struggle. And that was a thing which I thought, like, okay, that is, I want to make it because of business. And then I started learning all about YouTube, the algorithm. I think I watched like a millions of free tutorials on how to get keywords and how and what makes sense and the strategy in YouTube. And at the beginning, it can be very, very frustrating because the first videos, you don't feel comfortable just talking to yourself to the camera and then uploading a video that no one watched it. And then anyway, it took like over now 1.5 years until I really got to love it and be there like on a weekly basis, or now I'm even trying right now on a bi-weekly basis. And yeah, but I think the main idea I had with YouTube, which makes me different to other tour operators is, or vloggers, is that I'm not a typical travel vlogger. I do and have some travel vlogs there, yes. But I am I call it an educative travel vlogger. So I am there giving travel tips and tricks all about Kenya. And this is for everyone, for male and female. So if you have male followers here, you can also follow my channel and just get all the tricks and the hacks. And yeah, I make videos to all kind of topics about whatever, how to travel on a budget, how to travel luxury, how to watch out, what not to do, what to pack, what to wear, what you see, like, combined with travel vlogs. And that's why I think now slowly my YouTube is catching up, and I hope it's going to continue growing.
Well, I know what it's like. It's very difficult. As you said, there's so many YouTubers out there, especially in the travel sector, and it's hard to get your name out. And as you said, sometimes when you put out video, who's do they watch it? That's the thing. So it is difficult, but I've seen it. You've grown your channel beautifully. You know, it's come to a stage where, you know, you could, because what will happen is you probably might hit like a slow growth, and then bang, it will go so high. You're like, oh my goodness, how has that happened so fast? So I'm sure that will be very soon. One of the things about Africa itself, a statistic I know is that not many people travel there pre-pandemic anyway, where 79 million visitors a year all over Africa. But and when you compare that to Europe, 790 million pre-pandemic. So what can be done to sort of get that gap down?
I think it's tricky for us personally to tackle that. But what I think which needs to be done is a major like media shift in terms of Africa. Africa is still seen as an underdeveloped one country, actually, not even different countries in this continent. And also, you see, I don't have to look far. Like, I just have to look at my mom or my dad. They only traveled in Europe. And they know I live here now for 7 years. I'm here for 7 years. And they have never come to see me because they have a fear inside. Like, my mom doesn't want to take long flights. That's where it starts. Then my father is worried about all the mystery he could see. So the problem is how Africa is being projected in European or in American media on TV. If they only show like the misery parts, people dying, people suffering, terrorism, something happens. And if that doesn't change, or if we now, okay, anyway, social media takes over. So if we don't keep on speaking up for Kenya or for Africa, for the beauty of Africa, because it's a safe country. Of course, there are some areas which are not safe. Of course, I'm not saying this. There are also certainly countries you shouldn't travel to in Africa. Of course. But also in Europe or in your own home city, there will be streets which are not safe for travelers. Even in Germany, in Berlin, you can't walk everywhere at the night. So you just have to be, how do we say, when you travel, you just have to be conscious about what you do. And I think it's for us to start making that change in social media, because social media takes over the TV and the radio anyway. So with time, we will have a change, because people have to realize that even in Africa, like we have, I live in a house, I don't live in a hut. It's like the thinking of Africa has to change. And as long as that thinking doesn't change, people are afraid to travel. But I think with all these travel vloggers, and especially in YouTube out, and they show reality in their videos, it's the only way on how you can make these changes happen.
I personally think that, so for example, yourself, we need more people like yourself who are out there constantly uploading, constantly showing a side to Africa that resonates with people. Go, oh, actually, you know, Nasinia's doing it, so-and-so's doing it. Maybe it is. So I think you need more and more of those as time goes on. And like Asia, for example, you know, years back, Asia wasn't visited, but now Asia, everyone likes to go to Asia. So over time, I think I say give it another 10 years with how social media, as long as it keeps trending, because more and more people are traveling to, and that will also help reduce the price as well. So it's places like Uganda or Rwanda, where if you want to go see the gorillas, very, very expensive, but eventually it will start to sort of come down where it's more accessible, more affordable for a lot of people. So telling the story that resonates with the Western world, so Westerner telling the story, will actually help. That's what I think anyway. And it's great that you're there, you're telling your story, and then hopefully, let's just see if I can get out there again. I've been to Africa a few times, but I didn't necessarily video myself at the time because I wasn't a YouTuber or anything like that myself at the time. But now, if I do go, I'd want to show a side to Africa where people, and I've got friends in the United States as well who've done something very recently as well, where, again, it's showing a side where it's absolutely beautiful, you know, not necessarily, as you just said there, people think, oh, you're living in a hut. Actually, you're living in a house, aren't you? So that those are the misconceptions that we're going to try and have to sort of bypass. And I think it will happen over time anyway. Congratulate you with everything that you've done with the business. So it sounds like it's on a nice trend, it's going up. But you have settled and not gone back to Germany. And you mentioned that your family, your parents have never visited, I should say. What's your situation like in Kenya?
So actually, to my personal level, I have settled down in Nairobi now. And up to last month, I was still traveling, but I am pregnant in month 8. So,
congratulations.
8, I'm getting my first baby boy.
Oh, congratulations.
So I am married to a Kenyan, but he's not a traveler at all. So I still do travel solo. I do travel with friends. So I do any kinds of travel nowadays, and also of course with partners, and just to go and check out lodges. So I still travel solo. So that's my personal situation. Directly in Nairobi, and of course now I have not gone home for it's over 1.5 years, and even the last time I went home was just like for a week. So my next international trip will be definitely home with my baby boy, hopefully if everything goes well, and seeing my family, and especially I miss my grandmother, because for her it's not that easy to understand why I am here. Yeah, so that's my personal situation here. But I cannot, for myself, I have decided, I cannot even imagine of going back or living in Germany, because the life I have created here, and I have so many dreams and goals where I want to go and what I want to do, which are simply not possible in Germany.
Of course, no. By the way, congratulations. I didn't realize you were pregnant and you're about to have your first baby very soon. It's great that you settled, and sometimes it's, I guess when you've got a mission or a goal with business or anything, sometimes your social aspect or your personal life can take a bit of a backseat. But it sounds like you've found a nice balance, and it's fantastic to hear. And as you also said there, or something I picked up, you said your grandma still doesn't understand why you've moved. I guess it's that older mentality, old-fashioned mentality, you know, why have you gone to a place like Africa? So it's great that you've actually settle beautifully again, and as I said to you, I wish you the best of luck with that when it happens. I'm sure you will give yourself some time off before you get back into work again, or will you continue to work?
I'd be not planning to. I mean, it's my first child, so honestly I don't know what's going to happen.
Slightly different, isn't it? If you were working for someone, then you can take 9 months off or something, but when it's your own business, I guess taking time off isn't really a option, is it?
And as well, you see, okay, the good thing is that I can work from anywhere. So now I'm just home. In 2-3 weeks, I decided no travel anymore. I'm too far. I have to stay around Nairobi. And so I can work from anywhere. And I will most likely get a nanny who supports me, so that a few hours in the day, I can be on sales calls, I can talk to clients, I can work on engineering. So I will definitely start like that. And then I hope by the end of the year, actually in December, January, it's the first time I want to travel back home to Germany. And then from there, I think, I'm planning, that's my goal or my dream. I want to continue and also supporting travelers, or maybe single moms or moms who travel with a baby. As I said, my husband is not a traveler, so it will be still me being traveling with the baby. So I want to also create content on, is it possible to travel with a baby in Africa? How can you travel? So of course I grow, so also my YouTube channel will go with me a little bit in that direction, but still giving support on general travels, of course, and cultural travel. So I'm not planning to stop any travel. Just, of course, the first few months, obviously. And then the way of traveling will change the moment you have a baby, obviously. So
that sounds really interesting, actually, traveling with the baby through, a continent where not many people would do. So that's actually, I'd be very intrigued to see that. One question before I let you go. In terms of where you see your business now, development-wise, where would you like it to be in the near future?
That's a good question. So I'm still on a stage where I have a few clients, but I actually want to have the same business model, but with more clients, like, if that makes sense, like to a bigger, just with a bigger revenue. But the way my business is structured, I want to continue it exactly the same way. The only thing I wish to be right now is to be able to be more on the road, like to explore and experience even more. So, I mean, I've been traveling a lot. I cannot complain at all. But where I'm seeing myself is that I'll be sponsored by more lodges or by organizations who reach out to me and tell me, okay, Sinja, we have a cultural event here. There's this tribe here. So I want to make way more content about the tribes of Kenya and experience it myself, and also vlog about it, because that's my personal my personal interest, and I want to make it happen in a bigger, like, my dream is, because I started my organization in Ithaca, which we have 22 children, and right now, the German organization, they are to 90%, 99%, they're our sponsors. But Travel with Sinja, I want to take part of that, like at least 30, 40, 50% if possible of the every month's cost. So my dream is this Travel with Sinja to make a real impact in the society here. I mean, we already do with our travels because our money goes back to the communities. But also I want to be able to choose organizations which I can additionally support and really make a big difference, so that we can, instead of the 22 kids we are having now, we can go and maybe have 30 kids. So that's my personal goal in a few years. And I'm pretty sure I get there.
I'm sure you will do. No, I'm sure you will do. Well, I'm going to wish you the best of luck with that. I wish you the best of luck on your personal, you know, with your baby. I can't wait to hear about it. And it's amazing talking to you. It has been amazing talking to you.
Thank you so much for having me. I'm super excited and honored.
Thank you.
It was a pleasure talking to Sinja about her passion and her business. And I am pleased to confirm that she has given birth to a healthy boy. If you're interested in following Sinja and using her business to visit Kenya, all of the details are on your screen now.
That's it for Take a Wonder with Shebs. Hope to see you all very soon. Until next time. Bye for now.